Do you sometimes pay immediately at the moment that you receive your merchandise from your vendor? Well, then you should watch this video, Purchasing Merchandise for Cash. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. We pay vendors immediately for merchandise that we receive today. We can write a check if that's what we're giving them, or if we pay online, we can use the expense type of transaction that QuickBooks Online makes available. The result will be the same. Our cash will be negative temporarily until we start selling. So just for illustrative educational purposes, just imagine we have a line of credit with the bank and we will owe them in our bank account until we start selling. That will help you understand the numbers a little bit better. So what happens in our QuickBooks records at the moment that we purchase inventory and pay for the inventory immediately? Well, the cash in the bank goes down, and in our case will become more negative, and the inventory asset that we discussed in a prior video will increase. That inventory asset represents the total money that we paid for all of the merchandise that we currently have. For example, let's imagine on January 2nd of 2020, we paid Addie's Orchard with check number 2 to buy 100 apples that we received today. Can you guess the check amount? Well, if you remember that we buy them for $10 each, because that's how we set it up in the items list in the previous video, then $10 each and we buy 100 means we're paying Addie $1,000 to buy inventory. Now, this is what the trial balance looks like before we record this check. But if we pay $1,000 to purchase inventory that we still have, it means $1,000 will show up as the balance of the inventory asset. And if we paid from cash in bank and we already have a negative $300, that means cash in bank will become more negative and it will become $1,300 on the credit side. And this is what the trial balance should look like after we write our check for our first merchandise purchase. From the top left, we click New, go over to where it says Vendors and click Check. And here we are writing check number 2. The date we're writing the check is January 2nd of 2020. The payee is Addie's Orchard. Now, you have to be careful down here. You probably see category details, and you probably don't notice item details. You have to click the triangle up to remove category details because we're not paying an expense, and click the triangle where it says item details because we're buying something that's on the products and service lists. So after you open item details, click directly under the word product service to bring the pull down arrow. Now, choose apples. Notice QuickBooks remembers that the rate per apple is $10 each, and we're buying 100. That means we're writing a check to Addie's Orchard for $1,000, and we have $1,000 worth of inventory in our warehouse and in our records. Now when we click Save and Close, the numbers on the trial balance are exactly as what we predicted in advance. We have $1,000 worth of inventory and a debt to the bank of $1,300. But there is another place to check the results. If we click Reports and we click Inventory Valuation Detail, you can see that the reason why we have $1,000 in the inventory asset is because we have 100 apples that we pay $10 each, and if the cost is $1,000, that means the asset value is $1,000. So this report explains the details of the inventory asset account in the trial balance. And now let's imagine on January 3rd, we paid Sam's Farm with an online transfer for 100 bananas that we received today. Can you guess the amount? It's not really a check, it's an online payment, but can you guess the amount? That's correct. That would be $2,000 because we buy them for $20 each and we're paying for 100 of them. So the amount we're giving is $2,000. So what will be the result in the trial balance after we pay this $2,000? Well, cash will become very negative, $3,300. But inventory asset will increase from $1,000 to $3,000. Because if we pay $2,000 more to buy $2,000 more worth of inventory, that means the account increases by $2,000 and we will now have $3,000 worth of inventory sitting here in our warehouse available for sale. So if we're not writing a check, we click New, and if it's an online transfer, we click Expense. Now, you may notice, let's close this. You may notice the expense window is the same as the check window. We're paying Sam's Farm. Remember, we're not paying for services or expenses. You have to click Item Details. The date, by the way, is January 3rd that we're actually paying. And in the reference number field, you should put the number that the bank or the company gave you as the transaction number so you can trace it back later to the statement. But it's the same idea as check number if you're paying online. Now click directly under product and service and this time choose bananas. QuickBooks remembers we buy them at $20 each because that's how we set them up in the items list. And if we are buying 100 of them, that means, only 100. That means we're paying Sam's Farm with an online transfer of $2,000 to buy $2,000 more worth of inventory. Click Save and Close, and now the numbers are exactly as what we expected. We now paid a total of $3,000 for inventory, and we now owe a lot of money to our bank. But you may well ask, why do we have $3,000 in the inventory asset? The answer is in the report called Inventory Valuation Detail. Double click and you will see, go to the right a little bit. If we have $1,000 worth of apples, and now we also have $2,000 worth of bananas, that means the total asset value here is $1,000 plus $2,000. That means we have $3,000 of inventory available for sale, and that's the reason why inventory asset says $3,000.